Hi, I'm George Pearson. In this Adobe Photoshop project video, we'll be doing this illustration technique based upon this photograph right over there. Now, if you enjoy this video, make sure you click that like button and, of course, share with your friends. Also, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss on any videos in the future. And if you want to learn a lot more about Photoshop, take a look at my complete training course and you'll find a link for that right down there in the description right below this video. Okay, let's get to it. This colored art technique is loosely based upon a technique I've shown previously where I show you how to do a line drawing effect and give it a blue line. So it looks kind of like an architectural drawing effect. Same basic concept in here, actually starts out the same way. Once we get into the color, we move things in a different direction. Look, let me show you how that's done. Let's just close this down, get that saved. There we go. So here's the original. And you can download this picture if you want to. There's a link for that also down there in the description. Okay, let's go ahead and we'll start off by just making a copy of this layer. I like doing this to make a copy whenever I'm working on something so that I have a safety just in case I mess things up. I can always go back to my original, which is right there, instead of having to go up back and find the original picture and bring it back into my working file. So there we go. We'll be working on this copy as our basic copy. And the first thing you want to do is you want to convert this into black and white. So let's just take this, go up here to Image, come down to Adjustments, and then black and white. Lots of options in here, as you can see. I'm not going to bother going through all of these things and trying to find the exact black and white. Let's just do it easy. And that's by looking at the drop-down list. Now, what I normally do is I'll just go through these and I'll go down one at a time and see what they look like and make a decision from there and then possibly readjust afterwards. And I've already done all that, of course, and what I liked was the neutral density, and that worked out pretty well. I think that's a good look for this. So neutral density and choose OK. There's the black and white version. We'll now make a copy of this. So drag this down to the copy layer button right down there, make a copy of that. And we're going to be making this or converting this into a negative version of this. So go up to Image, Adjustments, and Invert right down there. Mix a negative. We're now going to blend the negative into the positive. Combine these two layers together by using a blend mode. So go up here to our blend modes where it says normal, and then come down here just a little ways down to color dodge, and what you'll get is just a plain white screen. Now both of these images are on here, it's just that the negative is blocking out the positive and we're seeing a white screen. Then to get the drawing effect in here, we need to offset one of these two layers, and we'll offset this inverted layer on top. Go up to Filter, come down to Other, and we'll use the minimum option right here, and this will allow us to do a little bit of an offset on that. This kind of interesting little drawn effect, almost an embossed effect. Now the one that I'm using here is an offset of 5 pixels, which is real nice. I'm using the squareness option down here. That helps give us kind of nice dark outlines. And choose OK. So there it is, there's our basic outline. Now I want to increase the contrast in here, but first let's combine these two layers onto a new layer to do that. To combine your two layers, just hold down the Control, Shift, Alt, and E key, and that merges these two layers onto a new layer. We can go ahead and hide those, we're now done with those two layers. Now that we have this on just the one layer, we can put an adjustment layer on here and adjust our contrast. Let's go ahead and do that. So go up to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, and I'll use Levels for this. And where it says Use Previous Layer to Create Clipping Mask, make sure that is checked. This will then link this just to that one layer. And in here I can bring up the blacks like that. I can brighten the whites over here. And I can adjust the midtones to get just the look that I want on this. I want it pretty contrasty. And what I came up with my experimentation here was on the black, it's right here, I did 102 on that side. For my midtones in here, I have 2.60 on the midtones, and on the whites, 231. Really contrasty effect in there. Go ahead and close that down. This little arrow here, little offset, that just means that this is clipped to this layer and this is only being applied on that layer. Now I really pushed this to really push that look of this being drawn as opposed to a photograph, a modified photograph. I really pushed that whole drawn effect. Okay, now let's just set up something here for the future. We'll come down here just underneath our black and white layer. It says background copy two. Let's make a new layer right there. And let's just fill it with white. If your color's like this, just hit that invert button right there and go up here to the paint bucket and just fill that with white. We'll come back to that in just a little bit. We're just setting things up ahead of time here. Now right here is where we begin to deviate away from that blue line architectural look. A couple things that I've changed. I haven't straightened the picture out. I did it on purpose. I want to have more of a perspective look in here, so I left that in. Looks more naturalistic that way, more like a drawing. And also, I've pushed it a lot further on the contrast. Now we're going to do something with our color. With a blue line effect, we'd be doing a blue layer in here at this point and then blend the blue layer into this, colorizing these lines with blue. We'll be doing the same colorization, but we'll be using our photograph down here to do that colorization. So let's go back to the background, drag that down to the new layer button right there, making a duplicate of that. Pull this above everything, so it's at the top. There's our original picture. And we have it up here. I don't want to have this like this, like a photograph. Let me just go over here to my move tool again. There we go. So we're going to blur this out. We'll use a Gaussian blur on that. Go up to filter, come down to blur and Gaussian blur. Give it a real nice blur. 22 is pretty good. All I really care about are big blocks of color, as you can see in here. I don't really want to have any detail, just really big blocks of color, and choose OK. Now it's not strong enough color, so we have to come in and strengthen our color up quite a bit. We'll do that up here, Image Adjustments, and come down to Vibrance. And here we can bring up our Vibrance and our Saturation a bit. Let's make these a lot brighter. So maybe about 30 on each looks pretty good. I'll just type that in. So there's before and after. So I've really brightened those colors up. That looks like a fuzzy photograph. This looks like something where somebody had painted. And that's what I'm looking for, is that level. Okay, there's our vibrance. Choose OK. So there's our color. We're now going to blend this back into our black and white layer. Now all I want from this is the color. I don't want anything else. So go to our blend modes and come all the way down to color right down there. And that blends just the colors into our black and white. In this case, leaving the black lines and blending the color into the white areas. It's kind of different from what we did with the architectural blue line. On that one, we used a screen effect and it blends the colors into the black, so the black becomes colorized. That's not the effect I want. What I want here is color, and that keeps us with those nice dark black lines and then fills in everything else with this real soft color. Okay, so far, so good. Let's now add a little bit of texture to this. And we'll do that by adding some texture onto our black and white layer, but I want this to come on with a smart filter. So to do that, we need to convert this into a smart layer. So right where the name is, right-click on the name and convert to smart object. That makes that a smart layer. Now if I apply a filter onto this, the filter will then be a smart filter, which means we can go back and easily change it in the future in case you want to change the effect. So it just gives us some, a little bit of flexibility down the road. Okay, so now go up to filter and come down to filter gallery. And here we go. Now in the filter gallery, you can kind of see there's the picture right there. One I used is right down here under texture, and it's the texturizer, bottom right hand corner. It's actually the very last filter in here, bottom right hand corner. And on this one is sandstone, scaling of 100, relief of 4, and I set the light angle here at top left, then choose OK. That just puts in a little bit of texture. It's pretty subtle. You see now, since we converted this layer into a smart object or smart layer, the filter comes in as a smart filter. So I can show or hide that filter now. You can see it's very, very subtle. You mostly see it in the grass down below. But if I wanted to change this, just come back and double click the little icon right here. I can then come in and do some adjustments or modifications in here on this filter. Change blend modes on that filter. I can also double click on the name of the filter and bring back up the filter gallery. So it gives you a lot of control between these two options in here to modify or adjust this filter after the fact. So that's why I wanted to do that as a smart filter. Again, just gives you a bit more flexibility. Okay, now for a nice drawing look, I want to minimize the color a bit so that it's only in the center portion. And we also want to get rid of the stuff all the way out to the edges. If somebody is drawing this, they're going to draw the important part. They're not going to bother drawing down leaves and stuff and grass way out here, the edges of the picture. They leave all that alone, so you need to get rid of that as well. Doing some blocking here, in other words, blocking out some of the stuff. So let's go up here, and the first one we'll adjust the color, where it says background copy 3, and put a layer mask, little layer mask button right down there at the bottom. Click on that. There's our layer mask. Now white shows, you can see everything is showing right now, black hides. So by putting in a gradient in here, we can limit this. Now for the gradient, go up here to the paint bucket, click and hold. There's your gradient tool. First gradient here set is linear, the second one is radial. Click on radial, and it's black to white. Now this is the default. Upper left hand corner is your current foreground background colors. In this case, black to white, and that's perfect for us. But I want to pull this from the center out like that, and so I want white in the middle to show the middle and hide the outside. So we need to reverse that. Up here it says reverse. Make sure that is checked, and then your gradient should be white on the left-hand side and black on the right-hand side. And then just take your pointer here, come right down in the middle of your picture someplace, and drag it out to the upper right-hand corner. Up here somewhere is fine, kind of like that. And what that does is it gives you color in the middle, and it fades that color out towards the outside. So it's black and white out here, and it's color in the center section. You can adjust how much is in here by pulling this out a little bit further out. You get more color further out. Go a lot shorter, you get color just in the center section. So you can decide how much color you want. I'll pull it out about that far from the center. Looks pretty good. So the whole building is in color. Most of the bushes up near the building are in color. And the building fades out to black and white out along the outer edges. And that's perfect. Okay, now I want to take away this outside stuff so we just focus our attention on the middle section. And again, this is another layer mask. So come down to our black and white layer. That's where you want to handle that black and white layer. And then click on the layer mask button. There's our new layer mask. Now, as I mentioned, white shows and black hides. So if we use a black paintbrush on the layer mask on the outside, we'll hide all this stuff. So make sure your foreground color is black. That looks good. Go to paintbrush. Now I have mine set pretty large, you can see here. And let's just set the opacity up here all the way to the top. So it's opacity is 100%. And I have my brush at 180 right now. Hardness over to 0. So it's real soft. And about 180 pixels for your brush should be just about right. And then just on your layer mask, look for that outline. Make sure you're on the layer mask right there. Just start painting outside here. And I'm painting on the layer mask and just removing some of this stuff on the outside edge. Now I'm leaving it a little bit kind of rough in here, so it kind of comes in and out like that. It just looks more naturalistic that way. And the same thing over here. And we'll get rid of a good bunch of that right in there. Don't really need that. And there we go. So there's our nice black and white pencil sketch, or colorized black and white pencil sketch, all done from that initial photograph. Let's now see how this looks in comparison. I'll take the background layer here. Let's just make another copy of this, just like that. Let's drag that clear to the top of our stack. There we go. So there's the original, and there's our color sketch version. And if you like this video and you want to help support this channel, and you also want to learn a lot more about Photoshop, take a look at my training courses and you'll find a link down there in the description right down below this video. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.